considering everything that's happening in the world, it may seem misguided for us this morning to focus on the concept of friendship at a time when these days we frequently feel inundated with fear, stress, or anger. And yet, these are precisely the times when we must be diligent about caring for ourselves and one another. In times when we worry and fear feels like a tidal wave, we can easily lose perspective or fail to see the blessings in life or to remember that we are loved. And as I thought about this service, I'm very grateful for the generous conversations that I get with Ann Fuhrer this week. The late poet and philosopher John O'Donohue, on whose writings this service heavily relies, wrote, "In a vast universe that often seems sinister and unaware of us, we need the presence and shelter of love to transfigure our loneliness. This cosmic loneliness is the heart of our inner loneliness. All of our life, everything we do, think, and feel is surrounded by nothingness. Hence we become afraid so easily. The 14th century mystic Meister Eckhart says that in all human life, that all of human life stands under the shadow of nothingness, the umbra nihili. Nevertheless, love is the sister of the soul. Love is the deepest language and presence of the soul. And it is through the warmth and creativity of love that our souls are sheltered from the bleakness of that nothingness. Each of us has a deep longing to be seen, deeply and profoundly seen by another person. The human longing and hope for a life partner or special friend who will be that person who helps shelter us can be best understood in the Celtic concept of the soul friend, or Ankara. Celtic spirituality speaks most beautifully of what it means to have a soul friend. Yet long before the rise of the loving friendship found in Ankara, Aristotle envisioned the philosophical foundation of friendship as the art of holding up a mirror to each other's souls. I love that image of holding up a mirror so that a friend might truly see us and we them. Years ago, I found an old mirror in Japan that was made simply of polished metal. Older than the clear images we see now when we look in a modern mirror, it is a reminder that on a deeper level, to see clearly, perhaps in that polished metal, perhaps to see clearly, it's going to be essential for us to keep working, to polish the mirror, the image, to keep it clean and reflective. This concept of seeing clearly is also found in the Christian scriptures in 1 Corinthians, where it's written, "Now I see through a glass darkly, but then face to face," perhaps face to face with our soul friend. True friendship gives us the opportunity to see truly and clearly into another, into the heart of another. Two millennia after Aristotle, Emerson also contemplated friendship and believed that friendship was upheld by two pillars, truth and tenderness. Later, C.S. Lewis wrote, friendship is unnecessary, like philosophy, like art, like the universe itself. It has no survival value. Rather, it is one of those things which give value to survival. In every person's life, there is a need for a soul friend, and yet to seek to be known in this way by another carries risk. To be a friend, one must be willing to open oneself to another, to share our deepest secrets and our most vulnerable places. That's a scary proposition, causing us often to hold back from truly opening our hearts to deep friendship. What if the person with whom we share our innermost secrets and fears doesn't hold them as sacred? It takes a huge amount of courage to trust another person with our inner selves. What if we trust someone who is not worthy of our trust, who does not hold sacred our most vulnerable feelings? What if we can't overcome our fear of rejection or judgment by another person? And yet the larger question we must ask ourselves is, how will our life be diminished if we can't overcome our fear and learn to trust in the open-hearted? The Celtic understanding of love and friendship offers us a goal for our cherished friendships, the Anam Cara, the soul friend. In the early Celtic church, a person who acted as teacher, companion, or spiritual guide was called the Anam Cara. It was someone to whom you confessed, revealing the hidden intimacies of your life. This friendship was an act of recognition and belonging. It is an opening of the heart. John O'Donohue wrote, "The heart is the interface of your life. The human journey strives to make this interface beautiful. It is here that love gathers within you. Love is absolutely vital for a human life, for love alone can awaken what is divine within you. In love, you grow and come home to yourself. When you learn to love and let yourself be loved, you come home to the hearth of your own spirit. You are warm and sheltered." So I invite us to consider for a few moments, where is that safe hearth for us in the heart of our soul friend? Let us meditate for a few moments on our own experiences of friendship and ask ourselves, have I been one who can be trusted to be a soul friend? Have I held as sacred the heart of a friend? there a person in your life that you can call a soul friend and anakara? If not, what do you need, what do I need to consider in order to have such a deep friendship? If you or I have a soul friend, how do we and our friend nurture that deep soul friendship? Perhaps we do have a deep soul friendship in our lives. Perhaps we have a friendship or life partnership that we hope will move to that deep relationship where we trust our soul to another person. What a blessing that is. Our lives, whether or not at this moment we have that deep soul friendship, our lives are even more enriched by our extended circle of friendships that are nurtured as we learn and play and grow alongside other people of kindness and goodwill. As our friendships develop both in this community and other parts of our lives, we are able to create spaces where we can share both our joys and our challenges. It is a precious thing for us when we hold sacred space each Sunday for people to share personal aspects of our lives. So in trust, we share our celebrations and concerns today in friendship and in solidarity with one another. A friend is both a gift and an art. When we have an anamkara, our friendship cuts across all convention, morality, and category. We are joined in an ancient and eternal way with the friend of our soul. The Celtic understanding of soul friend did not set limitations of space or time on the soul, for there is no cage for the soul. The soul is a divine light that flows into you and into your other. This art of belonging that is awakened fosters a deep and special companionship. The kind of friendship one finds in an anamkara, O'Donohue argues, is a very special form of love. Not the kind that leads us to pit platonic against romantic friendship, but something much larger and more transcendent. O'Donohue writes, "The heart learns a new art of feeling. Such friendship is neither cerebral nor abstract. In the Celtic tradition, the anamkara was not merely a metaphor or ideal. It was a soul bond that existed as a recognized and admired social construct. It altered the meaning of identity and perception. When your affection is kindled, the world of your intellect takes on a new tenderness and compassion. You look and see and understand differently. Initially, this can be disruptive and awkward, but gradually it refines your sensibility and transforms your way of being in the world. The Anamkara perspective is sublime because it permits us to enter this unity of ancient belonging. This kind of soul friendship means you are understood as you are without mask or pretension. The superficial and functional lies and half-truths of social acquaintance fall away. You can be as you really are. Love found in soul friendship allows understanding to dawn, and understanding is precious. Where we feel understood, we are at home. Understanding nourishes belonging. When we really feel understood, we are free to release ourselves into the shelter and trust of another person's soul. This art of love discloses the special and sacred identity of the other person. The friendship, this kind of friendship, requires of us presence, attention, and dedication. I invite us to be willing to offer an invitation to those who would be our friends, that with trust and openness of heart, together we will discover deeper knowing of who we truly are. Rumi wrote, "Some nights stay up till dawn, as the moon sometimes does for the sun. Be a full bucket, pulled up the dark way of a well, then lifted out into light. Something opens our wings. Something makes boredom and hurt disappear. Someone fills the cup in front of us. We taste only sacredness." May we be so blessed.